Major General Tim Williams, the Adjutant General of Virginia, and I'm here with you today from the Ordnance Training Support Facility to give a talk about the M2 half-track. After all the experimentation and experiences with tanks in World War I, one important lesson was learned. There had to be a way to have infantry move with tanks. Even the slowest moving tank can quickly outpace a soldier on foot. So many nations began to develop a track vehicle with some armor to allow the riflemen to accompany the tanks. In the US, the Army created a hybrid, the half-track. The Army understood and saw the need for a better machine to handle the terrain of any battlefield. The new concept finally allowed for more modernized transport over soft or even uneven terrain. A lightly armored half-track vehicle was a requirement for a burgeoning US Army, and there was a deeper need for this vehicle to maintain a dual-purpose role within the ranks. First, it would replace the horse and mule as the prime mover for both artillery and supplies. And second, it would serve as an armored personnel carrier with reconnaissance capabilities. The M2 was a rear track driven vehicle with a wheeled front axle. She had a two-man crew made up of a driver and an assistant driver. A mount for an M2 Browning heavy machine gun was fixed above the forward cab, and up to 1,000 rounds of ammunition was generally carried. Seats for 7 passengers, including applicable field gear, could fit in the rear area. The M2 had up to 12 millimeters of armor thickness protecting the crew and the passenger areas, and up to 6 millimeters of armor around the engine block. The 147 horsepower engine was powerful enough to move the 9-ton vehicle with 9 soldiers and their equipment for 200 miles at 40 miles per hour. Although the half-track suffered from mechanical drawbacks of requiring both wheeled and track maintenance support, this model served the United States and her allies well throughout the World War II effort. The M2 saw combat action in North Africa, Europe, the Pacific, and it was even provided to our Russian allies on the Eastern Front. And models with quad 50 caliber machine guns, like this one behind me, were critically important in the Korean conflict as a direct support weapon. There were 13,500 M2s manufactured, as well as 3,500 M9 later models produced. Surprisingly, with its multi-mission capability, the M2 half-track served for well over 50 years in a number of armies around the world, and some were still in active service in Bolivia and other countries as recent as 2006. Not bad for a hybrid design, and frankly, probably one of the best reasons why this is my favorite when it comes to wheeled and tracked vehicles.